Hi everyone, how are you guys tonight? You guys, we are back here live on my page. My name is Brandy. I'm the owner and artist behind Brush by Brandy, and I wasn't live last week because I was gone on a trip. And I'm a little under the weather, so I'm gonna just, we're just gonna go live tonight and keep it easy and breezy and something simple that we can do together. You guys, my husband Sean, he is here behind the camera. What's wrong?
Hey, you're okay.
My husband Sean is here behind the camera. If you guys have any questions along the way, feel free to pop on and ask us those. I'm going to work on this chest. We actually started this one a couple weeks ago. You guys might remember. And it has a raised stencil on the front of it. And I've coated this in Wise Owl paint. The color that I used was Weathervane, which is a dark, dark charcoal gray. And then I had a little bit of gray linen in it. And at first I started out doing a blend, and then I decided to go ahead and just put on a solid color. So it's a little uneven, but that's okay because we're going to fix that with what I'm going to do tonight. And what I want to do is I want to add a little bit of dry brushing just to really subtly bring out the details in this.
I'm working the room.
You guys, Sean and I are really under the weather, so you guys know that I was gone last week. Well, we came home and a lot of people ended up with COVID, and that includes me. And then Sean got it too.
There is the bonus.
So we are both like barely conscious right now.
How's that tequila treating you?
Yeah, I'm trying to get back into the flow of working. I'm just now getting about back to where I can work again. So what we're going to do is we're going to dry brush some soft white onto this piece here. And I'm going to take, this is just a full natural bristle. I'm sorry, this is actually a synthetic bristle brush. And basically what I'm looking for is I want one that's kind of coarse. So I'm going to show you guys a few different options. Let's see.
I don't know, Cindy. I don't know if that's the man flu. She asked if I had the man flu.
No, you didn't. We were pretty sick. We've been pretty sick. This guy here from Wise Owl would work. So I just want a nice full bristle brush that I can lightly apply some paint with. So I'm gonna just take the paint or the lid of my paint here, and this color is called Cashmere. This is from Wise Owl, and I'm just gonna kind of lightly hit the tips of my bristles, but I'm actually gonna lay it off, and I'm just gonna use my floor. And then I'm just going to lightly dry brush over the top of this. And once I get a feel for how much paint I want on there, then I can kind of repeat it. I'm just using the lid. And I'm going to lighten up this whole look. But I want some of this gray is going to show through just a little bit.
Oh, Michelle said she saw you at the auction, but she was too shy to say hi. Huh. Michelle, I don't even know how to pronounce her
really?
Last name.
Really? Were you there? Oh my gosh. It was a lot of crazy. It was there was a lot going on, so it got really hard to meet everybody and pay attention to everything that was going on. So I'm sorry, Michelle. I tried to make sure that I made my way around to everybody and said hi and took photos as much as I possibly could. But although now that I'm sick, you're probably like glad that you didn't meet me because it means you probably would have ended up.
Stay clear of that one. If only.
Okay. Can you guys see how just adding this little bit of paint over the top, it starts bringing out that raised stencil, and I'm just going to keep going back and I'm going to keep filling my brush very, very lightly. I don't want a lot of paint on here. So you guys, there is something exciting coming from Wise Owl tomorrow too. This is Wise Owl paint that we're using tonight.
My birthday isn't until February.
No, it is definitely not your birthday, but it is a little present that we're getting from Wise Owl tomorrow. You definitely are going to want to pay attention tomorrow to all the Wise Owl pages to see what's coming from them tomorrow. It's pretty exciting. So this color is called Cashmere. It's a soft white, not a full, pure bright white. And I actually think I want a lot of this dry brushing, but I'm gonna keep doing it slowly because I'd rather need more than less.
Thanks for asking, Mary. The boys are okay for now. Yes. We had a scary little bout, but
so far the kids are okay. But here's the problem: nobody could really avoid it because they had to drive me home from the airport, which is an hour drive from our house. So there was really no way to isolate from me when I got home. They had to be around me, and it ended up that my middle son did get a little bit sick. So we suspect he might have had a bout of it. But me and Sean definitely tested positive. So it's been okay. We're not super sick. We're just really tired. We have no energy. I haven't done a lot of work this week.
That's weird. Me neither.
Work every day.
So I'm kind of getting a feel for how much of this white that I want, and I feel like I like the area where I'm doing a little bit more of it, because I do want to lighten this up quite a bit. So that's okay, because then I just get a feel for how much of it I want to do, and once I have that kind of down, I'll just repeat it across the front of this. Let me actually try a different brush too.
Cindy says she has zero energy, but she didn't get sick.
Oh, you did? Well, I'm glad you didn't get sick, Cindy, because that part is no fun. A lot of people got sick. I would say, I don't know, half.
Is that just the teachers?
No.
Oh, thanks, Amber. She says, wait for the fallout after. That was the worst part of COVID for her. And I did hear that from a couple of people today, that it was just the, like it just hangs on. And somebody said that it would affect, you know, like marathons and whatnot. And I said, well, good. I'm not having to run a 10K anytime soon, so I think I'm okay.
Yeah, there's definitely going to be none of that. So what do you guys think? I feel like I'm liking kind of this area right here where I'm a little more heavy on the white, and I actually like some of the unevenness that's going on. I changed to this brush. This is a country chic brush, but I like that it's a little flatter. And I might layer actually some different whites on here too.
Yeah, everybody's really digging that stencil.
Oh, I love this stencil. This stencil is super pretty. And what's funny is you don't really notice it when it's in the solid color, but when I start the dry brushing over the top, then you can start really seeing the detail that's in this stencil. So it kind of was lost, and this is just going to bring it back. And at first I started out thinking that I wanted to blend this, and I did a blend over it, and I felt like even still the stencil got lost, and I really want this stencil to stand out. So I think this is gonna give it kind of like a layered, like a little bit of a worn look. I'm liking this brush a little bit better. It's a little firmer, and it's leaving me some really nice brush strokes. And then I think I might grab some snow owl.
Hey, Mama. Sorry, Logan has a question for you.
Yes. What's the texture under the dry brush?
It's just got a regular coat of paint on it. So it's picking up the raised stencil. Oh, I'm sorry. You're probably asking about the raised stenciling. This is a raised stencil. We did this on this piece a couple weeks ago on my live. And I used a joint compound and then a stencil from Royal Design Stencils. And the name of this stencil, oh my gosh, if somebody were to ask me that.
What's the name of that stencil?
Yeah, that's a great
Sheila's
question.
Sheila's on, so I'm figuring that that's going to be the next question. Just because it's Sheila.
So I really like how this looks right here. I'm going to grab some snow owl, which is a pure white, and I'm going to layer that with this. Yeah, I super like that. just that little bit of gray peeking through. Plus, this is for my sister, so she has to like whatever I give to her. She doesn't really have a choice.
That was like a twofold laugh. That was a laugh at what you said, and then it was a laugh at Sheila.
You guys, though, my sister, she did have her baby. You guys have been following my page for a while. She had her baby while I was gone. All right, let me grab my other brush here. And I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to dip into it using this brush I started out with. And then I'm going to lay it off onto my floor. And this is a much purer white.
What do you do if you get too much on there?
Well, you have a couple choices. You can come back with your undercolor, which is that weather vane that's underneath. And I could just recoat that spot with my undercolor. That's probably what I would do if I got a little too much. I just really try to keep my brush nice and light. I don't want a lot of paint on it. And what this pure white is doing is it's just hitting those high points, and it's highlighting those even a little bit more. So I'll have the contrast of the creamy white and then the pure white. It's very subtle.
And can you wipe it off?
Yeah, you could. I could come back and wipe this off. I didn't seal the weather vane, so if I get it wet and I rub at it, I could reactivate that too. So I would just do that cautiously because I didn't seal my undercoat. I actually really like the brush strokes. It starts looking kind of like a linen. Like this is a good spot right here where I've got some nice brush strokes. But I could just come back and do a little bit of, let me show you my darker color that's underneath. If I open up my weather vane, and I'll show you on a spot somewhere like here.
Oh man. Yes, Sheila. Was that a COVID sneeze? It was a COVID cough. Aftermath.
So if I were to take a little bit of my darker color, and I could just come back and kind of dry brush that back over the top.
Contagious.
And re-darken that. Yeah, you definitely don't want to sit too close to Sean. It's pretty miserable right now. So that's all I would do. If I feel like I got a little too much, I would just probably come back with my base color and darken that area a little bit. All right, I'm going to come get this molding right here too. And I just want to hit this fluting a little bit. And I will use some waxes on this to kind of accentuate some of this detailing in around here. I think on the top, I'm going to do like a faux wood top on this. I originally thought of it, I would just sand it down to the wood, but it's not a very high quality top. And so when I started taking it down, it just didn't look very nice. And so I went ahead and put a coat of paint on the top. I'm just going to move my way across the front of this a little bit and start coming in and getting some of these areas like here. I'm using vertical and horizontal brush strokes, very little paint on my brush, and it means I have to refill my brush a lot. And then I'm taking off all the paint, like I'm working that brush onto there until there's no paint left on that brush.
Refurbished gentleman is on.
Hey Mark, how are you? So you guys, when I was in Florida, Mark from Refurbished Gentleman came out, and I actually got to meet Mark for the first time. We've been friends for, I don't know, 5+ years.
That's weird, because there were a few comments. I thought you guys had been together for a while. Like,
Mark.
As if that was me. Yeah.
Because I came on live, and I asked people, does anybody know who this is? And they said, is that your husband? And I was like, nope, that is the wrong answer. Because you're going to get me in trouble. Mark We came home and most of us got COVID. I haven't talked to you since. But I've been really sick all week.
He did catch those comments.
Okay. Oh, yeah, that's right, because he was on live with me. Mark, did you get sick at all? I guess here's the point, too. Most of the people who had COVID before did not get it again. But
he didn't.
You didn't get sick? Man. A lot of us got sick. So, like, people who had it recently ended up not getting sick. One of those was not me, clearly.
Not it.
How are we supposed to know?
So I'm doing a little bit of the snow owl here. So this is a snow owl. I've got a little bit of the cashmere, which shows up. It shows up a little more yellowy up against the pure white of the snow owl. So I like what's going on here. I just knocked my water over.
So that joint compound, it doesn't soak up anything because you already have a coat.
It's already sealed. So after I did the joint compound, I sealed it in a coat of shellac, and that creates a barrier so that I can paint over the top without reactivating it. If you do not give it that barrier, it will have a tendency to want to reactivate. So you want to make sure you can't just come back and put paint over the top of it. You need to create a barrier. And I like shellac versus clear coat. Because even clear coat, if you brush it or you sponge it, that friction is going to want to cause the joint compound to reactivate. A little bit too much on my brush, so right away I just dabbed it off onto my floor a little bit instead of putting it onto the surface. You can tell pretty quickly if your brush is loaded a little too heavy.
Huh. I might give that a shot, Sandy. She said for your cough, put Vicks Vapor Rub on the bottom of your feet and then put socks on.
You haven't really had a cough. I've had the cough.
Yeah, I get it. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess at night you've had a little bit. I've been working the humidifier. It's at the tail end, guys. I've been pretty quiet all week, but I've been sick all week. So this is nothing in comparison. So I really like this spot right here, and it might kind of go. I've got a lot of horizontal here, and I want to break it up, so I'm going to break it up with a little bit of vertical.
Oh, you know what? Pam threw out another idea. You'll probably be a big fan if I do it. If I put onions on.
Oh yeah, please do that. I would say the other consequence I've had is sitting on a concrete floor all last week is I came home and have not been able to sleep because my body has been so achy. I broke my hip and my pelvic bone in a car accident years ago. And so if I sit for too long, I have to be really careful. And that did it, man. Sitting on the floor like that. So I'm kind of going back and forth between the snow owl and the cashmere. I'm using one brush.
Oh, man. Woolly socks, though. See, I can't.
No, it's too hot. It's also been 900 degrees in California this week. That didn't help either. So, like, even the thought of socks.
Yeah, just socks, period.
Yeah.
And you're going to throw wool ones at me? Come on now.
Oh, my gosh. We have our first fire of the season going on locally, too. So, that's not good. I really like this. So, I'm just, every once in a while, I'm going to back up and just look at what I've got going on. I've got spots that are this nice pure white, and then I've got the creamy white. I feel like I need a little bit more here. So I'm just gonna work off everything I've got under my brush right there. I feel like I need a little bit more here. I just want this really worn texture. So it looks like a tapestry.
Yeah. I'm coughing a lot out here.
Dad, you could throw those wool socks. You could make steel wool socks. Or you could make the onions.
This is why I have my think tank.
Definitely not you.
That is, this spot just came out really pretty. I just added a little bit more here. Let's come over here and work this a little bit more.
So how did you prep the piece to actually put on the stencil?
Oh gosh, what did I do? It does have Wyzel primer on it in light gray. I put underneath a coat of Wyzel primer in light gray, and then I put my stencil over that, and then I sealed it in shellac and gave it a coat of my dark gray paint, which is weathervane.
Looks nice, Mom.
It will. It'll get there. Because I have, then I have the sides and the back to do too. So it'll take quite a few brush strokes to just get this really soft. Areas where I want a little bit more, I'm just working whatever little bit of paint I have left in my brush, which is barely anything. I'm gonna try doing kind of a swirl on there too, seeing if I like that. I think that I do. All right, let's come get over here a little bit. So this overall is a pretty simple finish. It's a lot of brush strokes and just keeping the paint on your brush really nice and light and just letting it pick up the texture in that raised stencil until you like the look. So I can do just a little tiny bit of the paint, and if I want to keep it mostly dark, but I really want to lighten this up quite a bit. I actually like how some of this starts getting nice and light. My sister's house is neutrals, kind of beiges, grays. She's exciting for color, huh? Does she even have any color? I think it's all neutral beige and gray.
Yeah. I think it's bright pink.
All right. And I'm getting a little heavy on the cashmere, so I'm going to come back with a little bit of the snow owl and just... I did like how that swirling looked, but I'm going to wait until my paint is pretty dry before I come back and do that, because I don't want to mess up the work that I've already done. I do like this brush. It's nice and firm, so it does the dry brushing really well. It's firm, but it's still full. It's got a nice full head on it. So this brush is working pretty good for this. All right, same thing over here. I want to get this fluted detail. What do you guys have planned for a 4th of July weekend? It's coming up. I don't think we're going to do much of anything because we've been so sick. So you guys, I need to live vicariously through everybody.
That's a real bummer.
Well, we also live in California and fireworks are illegal in our county. So unless it's a big organized show and a lot of places aren't doing them anymore.
Didn't you see fireworks last weekend?
No.
Yeah.
We went to the one local show last weekend. Well, Sean and the kids did. I was still sick at that point. I was flying solo on the COVID bus at that point. Nobody had joined me yet. And then Sean felt bad, and so he thought he would come on over. And all right. Yeah. So I feel like this is a little drier now, and I'm going to do this swirling, which I really, really like how that picks up the detail. So I've got the vertical and the horizontal brush strokes, and then this kind of gets into all those crevices.
Nice, Pam. That's thanks really for the great invite. Even though she really didn't invite. She said staying home, but she's traveling on the 5th to the lake home in South Carolina.
Oh, man.
I take that as an invite. Yeah. Go ahead, go ahead and pin that. Awesome. Send it on over.
Is that Pam Jacobs?
No. Barker.
I'm just trying to keep track of where my invites are coming from. Although nobody wants to be around me right now.
Yeah. Oh, there's the invite. Y'all can come too.
I never want to see another airplane again in my life.
Pin it.
We're done with the live now.
Yeah, we are staying home for a while.
Yeah.
This girl is burnt out. But I missed my live last week, so I figured I'd at least come on and do something, and this is pretty simple. I got a little heavy right there, but I think I'm still okay. It's just one little spot.
Oh, Marsha invited us. See, here we go. Marsha invited us up to her lake home in Michigan.
Oh my gosh, you guys, with all the lake homes.
Here we go, making it happen.
Well, you know, we have lakes in California, but you can't buy a home on them because, you know, well, number one, a lot of lakes in our area don't sell property on the water.
Truly on the water. Yeah,
yeah. You can't own the property. And then the few that you can are pretty far.
Oh, good deal. Thanks, Ashley. Well, you keep yapping. I'm going to jump in and zoom in.
We'll be lucky if we even get a flight.
Well, we are not flying anywhere, my child.
Yeah, no.
If you need us, we will be comfy in our bed at home.
I will be comfy in an airplane.
And then did you do the top?
Or? I have not done the top yet. I think I'm going to, it doesn't have the raised stencil on it. I think I'm going to do a faux wood look on the top using the same grays and whites that I'm using on the front, but it'll have a different texture.
Someone invited us into Kentucky.
Ooh, Kentucky was really pretty. We went there.
Someone you might know.
Yeah, we went to Tennessee and Kentucky was fun. We saw the
Someone
kings.
I might know?
Thank you, Sherry.
We saw the
Oh, Sherry.
Come on over.
Oh, man.
Be there before the live's over.
I love it.
Alright, go.
Happy birthday to your grandbaby, Sherry. So cute. Alright, so let me shut this. It does have safety hinges on it. So I feel like I don't want to do exactly the same thing on the top because it would get a little monotonous. So I'm going to do something different on this top. I think I'm going to take the same whites, only I'm going to run a wood graining tool through it so it has a little bit of different texture. That's kind of what I'm thinking for the top. So I really like this. I'm going to keep going and probably do a million more brush strokes on here, but I like how it just hit the top. I like how it's not all even. It looks a little worn. And I'm going to keep probably playing around with this. I want to keep that dark in there, that contrast. So that's kind of my plan for this one. I want to keep it overall pretty simple because my sister is not a very flashy person.
What?
I know. But I am tending to like the areas that have a little bit more versus less. So
we do have a lot of people asking that about that stencil.
Oh man, you guys are going to make me find what stencil this is. This stencil is called. It's not over there. It's from Royal Design Stencils, and the name of it is. Yeah, I was going to say it's some weird name. I swear that's the name of the stencil. I'm not lying to you. It's a terrible name. Damascus. No, it's fine, sweetie. Don't bring it over here. Damascus. Damask.
Calling names?
Yeah, I'll put a link to it in the description.
Yeah.
Because I do have an affiliate link for Royal Design Stencils. It's a really pretty stencil. They have some wacky stencil names on a couple of them. So that's all. I'm going to slowly figure this out. I'm tending towards these areas that I have a little bit more of the white in them. I just really want to lighten this up. I don't want it to stay too dark, and I like this more creamy white with just a little bit of the dark in the background. And it starts hitting the edges of the stencil really pretty. So I think that's kind of what I'm going to go for. It grabs a lot of the texture of the stencil and then the brush strokes that I'm creating with the vertical and the horizontal. It is pretty.
That's one. You want to say what the color is on the paint?
What's the color on the paint?
Okay, so I've got Wise Owl's Snow Owl, which is this really pure white. My background color was Wise Owl Weathervane, which is this dark charcoal gray. And then I'm also using a little bit of Cashmere, which is a sort of off-white. I'm tending to like the cashmere a little bit more, but I do like the contrast with the pure white and then the pure white of the snow owl and the creamy white of the cashmere is really pretty together.
Oh, what happens if you do this piece and your sister hates it?
She can paint over it. She's more than welcome. I actually would encourage her to.
I can just drop it off the back of the truck and keep going.
Because it would mean my sister painted something for the first time ever. My sister is not crafty at all. Like, at all. Did I mention at all? So if she painted it, I would be super proud of her. Maybe I should do it on purpose just to try to get her to paint it.
Paint by numbers? Yeah, watercolors?
She would leave it like that.
Yeah, that's true.
She would just leave it like that.
Scratch it and don't over a ketchup kit.
Just get random colors in there and make it look like the rainbow.
Yeah, I really could probably do anything, and she'd just be like, yeah, it's fine, I like it, put it in the living room. It's great. We love it. It's perfect. She is one of those customers who is never disappointed. All right, guys. So I feel like you kind of probably get the gist of what I'm going to do here. I'm going to keep doing this for several hundred hours, probably, until I like the look, layering the creamy white and the off-white. I'm liking some of this area here. Over here, I need to do a little bit more. So I'll just work my way across it till I like the look of it. What do you guys think? And I should finish this up in the next, 6 to 8 weeks.
Yes.
How's it going, Mom?
I'm moving slowly. Thankfully, I do have my next YouTube videos are already pre-recorded because I'm not working very quickly right now. So bear with me, I will be back, but I'm just going to get through this illness first. I've dodged the bullet this whole time, so it was my turn.
Taking one for the team.
Taking one for the team, and Sean
Thanks
too.
Thanks for that. Thanks for taking one for the team, because you just committed me to do one too.
Hey, I did nothing of the sort. I feel like you just, it was like a sympathy illness. It was like when you saw that I was having the kids and you were like, well, I guess I'll gain 20 pounds too.
I guess I have to eat that tub of ice cream.
I feel like it was one of those.
Yeah.
Like,
can we go back to that? That was much fun.
I didn't need the camaraderie, but yeah. You were all there for it.
Did you get it on the plane? No, you didn't get it on the plane.
No, I did not. I got it from the event. I did not. People at the event were sick.
Cindy says, sorry that you got sick, but she wouldn't trade those hugs for anything.
Oh, Cindy, thank you. I wish I felt the same. Ask me again in another week.
Yeah.
I'm not quite there yet. All right, I will finish this up. I'm going to let you guys go because I'm just doing a lot of dry brushing here, but that was kind of the goal. That was all I had planned for tonight. So, again, you guys, my colors are Wise Owl, Weathervane, Snow Owl, and Cashmere. You guys are definitely going to want to pay attention to Wise Elf tomorrow, because there's going to be some stuff coming up that I think is going to be pretty exciting. You guys are going to want to see. So check out the Wise Elf pages tomorrow. I can't say anymore. It's killing me. But some pretty cool stuff is coming tomorrow from Wise Elf. So I'll be excited to share that with you guys.
It's my own birthday present.
Yes, it's a present for everybody.
My birthday too, Dad.
All right, you guys, I'm going to get off. Check out the link I put in the post for Wise Elf Paint, and then also I'll put one in the post for my stencil. Damascus.
No.
Damask. And you guys, I will get a YouTube video up. I don't know if it's going to be tomorrow. It might be Saturday. And then I should be back and get into my regular groove. This really, really threw me off. So thank you guys for being patient. And I'll get back to my regular posting and everything. I just have not felt up to doing much of anything. So even eating or sleeping sounds awful right now. So wish us luck, some more healing around here at the Colborne House, and we'll be back. You guys have a great weekend and a happy 4th of July. And thank you for hanging out. I'll talk to you guys soon.